Hi, this is Simon, and I want to talk about some analog audio arithmetic. Actually, I have two goals here. I want to talk about doing mathematical operations on analog audio in general, because I think it's just fascinating. And frankly, this was part of my inspiration to start working with modular synthesizers. I wanted to learn about doing audio math in the analog realm. But I also want to talk a little bit about the analog computer in this DU-INO Eurorack Arduino Shield. I just got this, so there's an Arduino inside of this. I'll probably grab some photos and cut them in here. I don't really want to take it out and show the Arduino behind it. The usual disclaimers, I'm not sponsored by anyone. This isn't a review of the DU-INO. I've only had this a very short time, so even if you ask me directly, I'm not sure if I would recommend it or not. One of the reasons I'm making this video is it's been hard to find a lot of documentation for this DU-INO. This was a Kickstarter project, so I know at least a few people have them. And so if you're working with one of these doing cool things, please hit me up in the comments, because I'd love to know what you're doing. One of my first questions about this module, though, was how does the not Arduino stuff work? So I dug into some of this stuff about the analog computer on board, and I thought I could make a video both helpful to people who are exploring this module and more generally, demonstrating analog audio arithmetic. Now, there are a ton of videos about this make noise maths by people far more experienced than I have, by people who invented the thing. I recommend you look at those. They'll explain things far better than I would. In the marketing materials, they call this an analog computer, and I think that's a really kind of cool term. And maths, of course, does way more sophisticated things than the analog computer on this does. One of my friends even remarked that it isn't even really a computer, it's just a single chip. But let's talk a little bit about what it does. Now, if you do any audio stuff on the computer, that's all digital, right? We take a waveform, we sample all of the amplitudes, and then it's actually pretty easy to do math on those amplitudes. But I just think it's really neat to do this all without any kind of digital conversion, and do it all in the analog realm, working solely with voltages. So you can program an Arduino to do whatever you want, but the analog computer on the DU-INO has one equation that it does. It does this minus this times this minus this. And then after that multiplication, it offsets that, so it'll add this voltage. I have a little display up here that's just showing the voltages that are either coming in or controlled by the knobs. These voltages can be set either with these knobs. So if I turn this way, we can see it goes up to 10 here. Maybe you can't see that, but it goes up to 10 here. If I turn that the other way, it goes down to, well, negative 9.9, so essentially 10. And same with all of these. I'm setting them back to about zero here. I'm trying to set them back to about zero here. But you can also take in voltages in here, either through LFOs, other control voltages. But to me, the really interesting thing is when we start to do math with audio signals. So let's take a triangle oscillator and run into this first input, and then we'll run that. The function is the output of that equation. We'll run that to our output. I can hear something that's very, very quiet. So remember, it's this minus this, so this is essentially zero, times this minus this. And so since these are both set pretty close to zero, we don't hear much. But if I were to turn this one, then we start to hear the sound because we're doing this multiplication. If I crank it a bit, we get some distortion of the waveform there too. Okay, so what we've basically created here is kind of a mixer. Now, what's interesting though is I can turn it up and down, but I could also go negative and invert the signal. So again, that would just reverse the phase of it, which is not something that's in most mixers. I could leave this at zero, and then again, remember, it's this minus this. So if I turn this up, again, now I'm inverting it. If I turn this down, that's just like turning up the volume on my mixer. I could set it so that this one is up, or sorry, I guess up is this way is up, and this way is up, and we're not hearing anything again, because again, it's this minus this. So I have knob 3 here at about 9 and knob 4 at about 9. And so 9 minus 9 is 0. So we're back to getting nothing. Interesting to think about too is, you know, this audio signal that's coming in, I'll just leave that up so we can hear it. This audio signal that's coming in is going from negative to positive. It's fluctuating like a waveform. I could take the second knob and I could make it, I'm getting a bit of distortion if I go too far there, but I can make it a unipolar waveform instead of a bipolar waveform. So I said we're doing multiplication here. It's important with all this addition and multiplication to understand the range is always going to be negative 10 to 10. And so if we go beyond that, our voltage is kind of going to clip at those values. So it's not going to be able to, even if I have, you know, things cranked here, 10, whoops. You know, that would be 10 times 10. That doesn't become 100 volts, right? Okay. Important to understand, too. I could send this to that second part as well. The second part of the equation, so that's the third input, and it has the same behavior. Same here, right? So, probably you're not as excited about audio arithmetic as I am yet, so let's think about what we can do with two audio signals. So let's keep this going in here, and now let's add, from here, this is another oscillator, let's put this into two. And once again, we still don't hear much, so it's this minus this. Okay, so this signal is being subtracted from this signal, so it's like what we end up with again is kind of like a mixer, only this second signal is going to be inverted. We can use 3 and 4 for this too. Again, same effect. Or we can multiply these signals. So 3 times 1. So if you know your modulation synthesis, when we multiply signals, we get a ring modulator. Let's take out that audio signal and let's set this to be an LFO now. So now with the LFO, this is a tremolo effect, right? I mean, that's kind of neat, but, you know, not as neat as a ring modulator. So, we can add more here. So, we've got our modulation synthesis going. We can do additive synthesis before we do modulation synthesis. So we can get some really sort of funny, complex sounds. Now, the point of all this on the Duino, apparently, is that you can keep your signals analog and use the Arduino microcontroller to digitally modulate an analog signal. So your audio or CV doesn't have to go through any kind of digital conversion, right? You don't have to convert the signal to be on the Arduino and then do the adjustments. You can keep your signal analog and then use the digital stuff just as control. They include an envelope generator in the examples, for instance, that can serve as a VCA. So it can take in an audio signal, create the digital ADSR control envelope for it, but not have to do that analog to digital conversion of the sound. As I said, I'm just getting started here. If you've been digging into this module for a while, please share what you're doing. I'll try to share what I know as I keep going here and try to find as many resources as I can.